हेलो एवरीवन, आई एम काजल झा, लेक्चरर इन प्रवीण पाटिल कॉलेज ऑफ डिप्लोमा इंजीनियरिंग एंड टेक्नोलॉजी, प्रोग्राम इलेक्ट्रिकल इंजीनियरिंग डिपार्टमेंट, क्लास EE4I, सेमिस्टर फोर्थ. कोर्स नेम इज़ डिजिटल इलेक्ट्रॉनिक्स एंड माइक्रो कंट्रोलर एप्लीकेशन. कोर्स कोड 22421. इन अ प्रीवियस वीडियो वी सीन दैट बूलियन अलजेब्रा of the unit 1, that is logic gates and logic families. In a Boolean algebra we seen the various laws, okay, used for the simplification of the Boolean expressions. Now in this video we will discuss the De Morgan's theorem and some simplifications, that is Boolean expression simplification, and why the NAND and NOR gate is called as universal gate. Okay, so we construct the basic gates using the NOR and NAND gate. Okay, we will see in this video. So let's start. Okay, first is De Morgan's theorem. The De Morgan's theorem, which are extremely useful in the Boolean algebra. So here the De Morgan's theorem consists of two theorems, okay, first theorem and second theorem, De Morgan's first theorem and De Morgan's second theorem. So De Morgan's first theorem states that when the or sum of two variable is inverted, this is the same as inverting each variable individually and then ANDing these inverted variables. Okay, that means De Morgan's theorem states that or sum of two variables, this shows that sum of two variables is inverted. This bar is shows the inversion. Okay, this is same as, means this is equal to the, okay, this is equal to the inverting each variable individually, okay, inverting each variable individually and we ANDing that variable, that is nothing but here dot. If we write here dot is, okay, it is not necessary to put a dot here, okay, we can write A bar, B bar also. Okay, the first theorem states that when sum of the two variables, okay, if we ORing the two variables and is inverted variables, then it is equal to the inverting each variable individually and then ANDing that variable. Okay, ANDing that variable. This theorem states that the complement of product, and in a simple way, the complement of addition is equal to the complement of product. Okay, the complement of addition is nothing but the complement of product. Complement of addition means what? A plus B is nothing but the addition, or it is also called as OR, and complement means put a bar over that, is equal to what? Product of sum. Complement of addition is equal to, complement of addition is equal to the product of the complements, product of the complements, okay, that is nothing but each complements, product of each complements. Okay, then second law state that De Morgan's second theorem says that when the AND product of two variables, okay, we will erase all that. Second theorem state that when the AND product of a two variables, that is A and B, AND product, and is inverted, means put a bar over here, then it is same as the inverting each variable individually. Okay, we can invert each variable, that is A bar and B bar, and then ORing that variable, ORing them. It is a second theorem of De Morgan's. Or we can say that in a simple words, product of the complement, okay, complement of product is equal to the addition of the complements, right? Because here we use the A dot B bar, okay, here we use A dot B whole bar is equal to A bar plus B bar. If you see here, okay, we simply write first theorem is nothing but or sum, that is or means what, a plus b, and make a complement of that, that is a plus b bar. Now dot is replaced by dot, plus is replaced by dot, and ending of each variable, that is ending of each complement, so a bar dot b bar. Now we will see the second theorem, that is the AND product of two variables, that is AND product is A plus AB is a AND product, that is nothing but A dot B is the AND product. Make a inversion of that is equal to what? Is equal to what? Dot is replaced by plus and complements. Okay, this is the simple format. Okay, ORing of the two ORing of the two variables and make its complement is equal to the ending of its complement. Okay, and second one, product complements, okay, complement of product is equal to the addition of its complement. This is nothing but the De Morgan's theorem, and it is very useful in a simplification of Boolean algebra. Okay, if we see the next, the what is the proof for this theorem? Proof for this theorem means what? A plus B bar is equal to A bar dot B bar, and A dot B bar is equal to A bar plus B bar. This will verify by using this truth table. If we see here, there are two inputs are present, so combinations will be 2 to the power 2, that is nothing but 4 combinations, and we know the 4 combinations. First start with 0, okay, so first we will see the 2 0 2 1, then single 0 single 1, okay, because the inputs are 2, so 2 0, then 2 1, 0 1 0 1, okay, means what? We make a half of 4, that is nothing but 2. If we see here, if the variables are 3, then the table combinations possible are 8, then we don't write the 3 zeros and 3 ones, okay, we will half that part, that is nothing but 8, then a half of 8 is 4, so we write first 4 zeros for A, okay, then 4 ones. Then for B, we write half of this, so 2 0, there is 4 zeros, so half of this is 2, so 2 zeros to 1, 2 zeros to 1. Okay, for a next variable, that is C, we write half of this, so 0 1 0 1, like that. Okay, so the combinations and the table for the inputs, write like this. So now we know, we will see the logic expressions and truth table of the logic gates. So here we can simplify this. So 0 plus 0 is 0, but it is inversion. So A plus B inversion. Okay, if we see here A plus B, what is the value of A plus B first? So 0 plus 0 is 0, 0 plus 1 is 1, 1 plus 0 is 1, and 1 plus 1 is 1. So it is not B, na, because the inversion is here, present here, so it is not B. So 0, inversion of 0 is 1, inversion of 1 is 0, inversion of 1 is 0, and inversion of 1 is 0. So this is the A plus B whole bar. Okay, now we see, now we see A dot B, okay, because we have to see, now we see A bar and B bar, okay, A bar and B bar we can directly see here, A bar and B bar, A bar kya hoga iska, 0, then here it is 1, 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, 0, okay, that is nothing but the complement of A. Now we take the complement of B, that is nothing but B bar. So 0 here, then complement of 0 is 1, complement of 1 is 0, complement of 0 is 1, and complement of 1 is 0. So the AND product of A bar dot B bar is what? We see here AND product of A bar dot B bar. So we will take this 1 into 1 is 1, 0 into 1 is 0, 1 into 0 is 0, and 0 into 0 is 0. This is the possible combinations. If we see the two tables, that is, okay, sorry, if we see the two tables, that is nothing but A plus B bar. First theorem says that A plus B bar whole bar is equal to A bar dot B bar. Then if we see the two table, then 1 0 0 0, and here also the combination output is nothing but 1 0 0. Okay, both are the both the columns are same, so the verify the columns for A plus B whole bar and A plus A bar dot B bar are same. So first theorem is verified. Now we will move for second theorem. Okay, second theorem is what? A plus B A dot B. So first we find out AND operation of AB. So AND operation of AB is what? 0 into 0 is 0, 0 into 1 is 1, 1 into 0 is 0, sorry, and 1 into 1 is 1. This is the OR AND operation for AB. Then now the bar of AB, total whole bar of AB is nothing but what? 0, complement of 0 is 1, then complement of 0 is 1, complement of 0 is 1, and complement of 1 is 0. Okay, this is nothing but the AB bar. Now A bar B bar, okay, now A bar B bar means complement of A is what? Here we place the complement of A, that is 0 1, then 0 1, 1 0 and 1 0. Here the complement of B is 1 0 1 0. Okay, so we have to add this. Okay, we have to add this. So we will get what? 1 plus 1 is 1, right? Then 1 plus 0 is 1. Then 0 plus 1 is 1. And 0 plus 0 is 0. Okay, so if we see here, the column number 3 and 4, that is A dot B whole bar and A bar plus B bar, the values are same. So hence the second theorem is also verified. And in theory exam, the De Morgan's theorem is compulsory ask. Okay, because we have a question that is a state and prove the De Morgan's theorem. Then first you have to state that first theorem and second theorem, and then you have to represent that first theorem by this equation and second theorem by this equation, and then and in the last you have to prove that theorem. Okay, you have to prove that theorem. Then you have to plot this truth table and verify that by using the AND and OR operation. Okay, now we move further, that is inversion law. Inversion law state that this law uses the NOT operation. Where the word is inversion comes, that means it is the NOT operation. Okay, that is the NOT operation. We will earlier we will see earlier that is NOT operation, that is A is equal to A bar. This is the NOT operation. But the double inversion rule is shown by the equation. So double inversion is what? The A gives the two bars over there, okay, and is equal to what? A. How it is possible? If we the law states that the double complement, okay, that is nothing but complement of the complement. Because if we see here, this is the complement of A. Then complement, if we say another bar over there, then complement of A bar. Okay, then complement of the variable equals the variable itself. If, for example, okay, we take an example. If value of A is 1. Okay, if value of A is 1, then what is the A bar? A bar is nothing but what? Not A, that is nothing but 0. But A bar is 0, then what is the A double bar? That is complement of complement. Then what is the complement of 0 is 1. So both are same. Okay, so this law, inversion law, will say that the double complement of any letter or any variable is equal to it was variable itself. Okay, means what? If we put a value of A is 0, then the double complement of A is also what? 0, the value or the variable value itself. Then next is other important rules are, okay, these rules are important for simplifying the Boolean expressions. that is a plus ab, okay, a plus ab is nothing but a, then a plus a bar b is nothing but a plus b, then a plus b dot a plus c is equal to a plus bc. These some important rules you have to we have to means we have to rememberize, that is a plus ab is equal to a, then a plus ab is equal to a plus b, and a plus b dot a plus c is equal to a plus bc. Okay, now we will go for why NOR and NAND gates called as an universal gates. In an earlier video we will discuss that is because of the NAND and NOR gate we will construct any other gates. Okay, so a NOR and NAND gate called as universal gates. A universal gate is a gate which can implement any Boolean function without a need to use any other gate type. The NAND and NOR gates are universal gates in a practice. This is the advantageous since NAND and NOR gates are economically and easier to fabricate and are the basic gates used in all IC digital logic families. The NAND and NOR gates are called as universal gates because they perform all the logical operations. Okay, now in the next video we will construct a NAND gate, we will construct the basic gates using NAND gate and NOR gate. Thank you.